Thanksgiving, one of the best times of year. It's awesome that we have an actual season where we really highlight the importance of gratitude and being thankful. And beyond the awesome, you know, turkey meals that we prepare and gatherings that we have, this is a time where we recognize the value of being thankful. It's interesting to me that in Scripture we're called to give thanks in all circumstances at all times. This is God's will for us. And so it led me, as I've been preparing for Thanksgiving and for this little time where we would gather today, to ask the question, why? Why is it so important? What's the benefits of being thankful and gratitude? That's what we're going to unpack today in this little Thanksgiving message. Let me first say Happy Thanksgiving and welcome. I am Pastor Jody Getson, lead pastor at Oxnaz Online, and I welcome you to our social community where we are doing digital church. And so I invite you, beyond just taking this message, I encourage you to get involved, to join our groups. We have an Oxnaz Daily Devotion group that you can connect with. This week, the conversations about gratitude and thankfulness and the stories have been absolutely uplifting. I encourage you, check that out today. But let's get into it. Why is gratitude so important that we would be called to give thanks all the time in all circumstances? Let's begin with a story. You know I love to tell those stories. This one you can find in Luke 17. It's the story of 10 lepers. Now, these folks were ones that had like a skin disease and it made them contagious. But sadly, they were set apart from their community. They were ostracized. They were, I'm going to say, looked at as disgusting and kind of dirty, gross. Put them separate. Don't let them mingle and mix. We don't want to be infected by them. Could you seriously imagine how challenging it would be? I mean, we understand prejudice a little bit in our world today. That's something that was absolutely their life, what they endured. And so as Jesus was coming into town this one day, these 10 lepers in this terrible situation in life they were in, they met him, they ran out to him and said, "Master, Jesus, have mercy, have pity on us," they cried. And you know, he looked at them and he said, "Go show yourself to the priest." Well, we might read that and think, oh, like, what a weird thing to say. But in their time, you would show yourself to the priest to be declared healed. This was the normal practice. So without saying it, he kind of said, go to the priest because you're going to be healed. Imagine if you or I were sick with a disease and we were in the hospital and told we were never going to get out. And Jesus walked by our door and said, go show yourself to the discharge nurse today. I mean, we would be like, really? Is this going to happen? I mean, I've heard of this Jesus. Is it really going to be for me? Imagine these lepers, the pain in their life. Imagine the hope when he said, go show yourself to the priests. And so it says that as they went, they were cleansed. Imagine. I mean, it's hard to even comprehend the miracle that this was and the transformation that it would bring to their entire life. And what was the response? It says one of them turned and went back to Jesus, fell at his feet weeping, "Thank you, thank you, thank you." One of them showed gratitude. And Jesus said, well, wasn't there 10 of you? Where are the other 9? Only one of you came? Think about it for a second. What would you do if you were the leper? What would you do today if God provided for that need that you were praying for? If God brought that breakthrough, if that miracle happened, if that victory, what do you do with it? Well, for some of them, apparently 90% of them, 9 out of 10 of them, they had other motivations, other concerns, other things that were on their heart, and they went off in 9 other directions. One went back to Jesus. Here's the truth. It's so powerful. I want you to grab it today. One main reason why we want to be a people that give thanks is because thankfulness leads us to God. Do you see that in the story? When we recognize the blessings that we have just received and we are thankful, we go to God with a heart of thanksgiving, and that brings us close to Him. When we take the blessings and run in 9 other directions, What does that mean? It certainly doesn't mean that we're thankful and draw us close to God. So ungratefulness and other priorities and other maybe selfish motivations and self-centered thoughts and ideas, they send us in our own direction, but thankfulness leads us to God. Let me show you one more benefit of thankfulness. We look at another story. Love those stories. This one in Exodus. God had seen his people. This time they weren't maybe needing a healing, but they were needing deliverance. They were being persecuted and in bondage. And so he brought a great leader, Moses, to deliver them. And this was the story of them coming across the Red Sea. Do you remember that? When the waters parted and look, the miracles of God. He parted the waters. They walked across on dry land. They get across, the waters close, their armies that are opposing them, their enemies, they're defeated. And then here they are in this new land. What does he do? Manna and quail from heaven, water from a rock. God provided. God did all this to bless his people. And in that moment, I know their hearts in that moment must have been amazed, overwhelmed, and full of gratitude. So then he calls Moses to take up an offering, to call it the people to give an offering. But when he did so, it's really interesting what he asked. He said, from what you have, ask those who are willing. Now that word breaks into two, and it basically says who have a generous heart. Those who want to, without any compulsion or any requirement, just voluntarily from the heart, that's the word willing, just want to be generous givers. And so when he called forth the generous givers, do you know what began to happen? They begin to give their time, their talents, their treasures, everything that they had. And it was so much that Moses had to say, stop. We have more than enough to do this. You need to stop giving. This is giving God style. This is giving from a thankful heart. So thankfulness not only leads us closer to God, thankfulness leads us to give. And when we give and God shows us all the blessings that we have, then we begin to be a people who are living in the overflow, people who are living in God's economy, where God, the great provider, works in and through his people. I want to show you a little equation. God plus my giving equals enough. When I give from a generous heart and you add God into that equation, there is enough. We live in this world of lack and struggle and like a mindset of lack. And really, we hold so tightly to things. But God is calling us to be a people that are so thankful, a people that are so moved by his love that we give and we give generously and we give willingly. And as we give, things are happening, needs are met, and there is enough. I'll show you the final example of this, the last story that I have for today. We see this in the church as it's birthed in Acts. In Acts chapter 4, after the Holy Spirit fell, the people were moved by the Spirit of God. It says they were one. They just were in such unity and love that was spilling between them. It says that they didn't even hold anything as their own. That they were in community and they would give, and as they gave, they would sell houses or lands or whatever were needed and just give the offerings. And these amazing words we read, there was no need among them. You see, some had more, some had less, but everyone gave and everyone had enough. And that's what God teaches us. That's what the scripture shows us, that we serve a God who is the great provider, and he says that he will give to us all that we need so that at all times there is enough, and that God would get the glory for this. It's crazy to me that Jesus spent more time talking about money, literally 130 times. You can find references in the New Testament in Jesus' words to money. Because he understood. This is a heart issue. It says that where your treasure is, there your heart will be. If your heart treasures stuff and money and hold on to that, then you're going to live with this fear and this tightness and this self-centeredness. And that's the direction and attitude of your heart that absolutely will pull you inward and away from God. But I'm going to invite you instead into a battle with God for who can outgive the other. I'm going to tell you that there's one place in Scripture. You can read it in Malachi where God said, these people are robbing me. Man, their hearts were hard. They weren't giving generous offerings to God. They were hoarding for themselves. And he said, I want you to test me. You give as I have called you to give and see if I won't open the windows of heaven and pour out so much blessing you won't have room to receive it. Test me in this. See if I won't do it. God's word is full of calls that we give, and it says it will be given to us, pressed down and overflowing. It's not about I'm going to now change my mind and I'm going to start giving so I can get more. Just understand that you are being called today into this adventure where your life becomes saturated with gratitude, where your mind becomes so fully aware that God is good and God is enough and the provider, that as you give willingly from whatever you have, it doesn't matter how big or how much, you give willingly from whatever you have, the needs will be provided and God will give back to you. It says to the one who sows sparingly, they will reap sparingly. But listen for you today. The one who sows generously will reap generously. We want to get into the ring. We want to jump in the boxing ring with God and see how much I can give and what he's going to give back. I'm going to give more and he's going to give back more. Guys, this has been truly, and I'm not being inauthentic or making this up, this has been the adventure of my entire life. Doesn't mean that I haven't lost businesses or lost money. Absolutely, I have. But God has shown me that if I am faithful to give, I cannot outgive God. And the blessings and the joy that have been in my life because I trusted that God, who calls me to give generously, will give back and we will begin this fun, crazy, awesome adventure. I've trusted it. He's came through, and I give you my promise. This will be an adventure that will change your life. We are called to be a people who are thankful, giving thanks all the time, recognizing the goodness of God. It will lead us close to God. It will lead us to give. And in giving, we join the most amazing adventure with God that our lives could ever imagine. I invite you to that today. Let me pray for you and then stay tuned. Don't leave me just yet because I have a few final closing thoughts. Heavenly Father, thank you for this reminder at this beautiful Thanksgiving season that you are the God who provides and that you call us to be a thankful people. Let not one of us listening today, let not one be the nine lepers who take the blessings and run in another direction, but let us determine to be a thankful people that will draw close to you, a thankful people that will give generously. And in giving, you will bring us into an abundant, giving, full life like we've never imagined. God, I want to call every listener today to be a radical giver. Lord, call them, touch them, equip them, and challenge them as you touch them today in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, that's the Thanksgiving message, but here's one more little bit. I want to encourage you, if God is speaking to you in this moment about giving, and maybe you sense that in your heart you've been a little bit self-focused with your finances and with your gifts, it's time that you serve God with your finances, with your heart. If you need to find a way to serve, send me a message. I'll help you with that. And if you would like to be a partner with us in our online church, reach out to me. This doesn't happen just naturally. It takes people who are willing to hear the call of God, to give generously, and to join this ministry. Where do you know that in the last months of COVID, we've reached over 500 people who have engaged with us as a church? It's incredible what God can do online, but He needs you. So I'm going to invite some of you today to partner with me in that. Send a message. And again, if this was a blessing to you today, give us a thumbs up, share it, join us, get deeper, grow with us. And my final word as I send you out with your Thanksgiving blessing is love God and love other people. And in that, be generous, passionate, radical givers. God bless you.